Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.1, Problem 4. This is Section 4.1, Problem 4. It says, write the initial simplex tableau for the problem shown below. And the problem they have is maximize z equals x1 plus 4x2 plus x3 plus 3x4. Subject to, and then there are a few constraints. The first constraint is 9x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 plus 8x4 is less than or equal to 650. The next constraint is 6x1 plus 2x2 plus 5x3 plus 2x4 is less than or equal to 480. And then the next constraint is 3x1 plus x2 plus 10x3 plus 7x4 is less than or equal to 520. And then after that, you have x1 is greater than or equal to 0, x2 is greater than or equal to 0, x3 is greater than or equal to 0, and x4 is greater than or equal to 0. So when they say write the initial simplex tableau, what they mean is write the first matrix for this problem. So what we have to do is each one of the constraints, other than the greater than or equal to zero ones, has to be changed from a linear inequality to a linear equation. So the first one of those constraints is the 9x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 plus 8x4 is less than or equal to 650. So as an equation, that would be written 9x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 plus 8x4 plus s1, I'm going to leave a good space, maybe about that much, equals 650. So now it's an equals because I added the slack variable. So now the next constraint that I'll convert to an equation is 6x1 plus 2x2 plus 5x3 plus 2x4 is less than or equal to 480. So I'm going to write the same thing except add an s2, and it'll be equal to 480. So that would be 6x1 plus 2x2 plus 5x3 plus 2x4 plus, and now S2, I want the S2 to be over a little bit from the S1 in the previous equation because I don't want them over each other. They are different variables. And now I can put equals 480. And then I have another constraint under that, which is 3x1 plus x2 plus 10x3 plus 7x4 is less than or equal to 520. So again, I will convert that to an equation. Instead of a less than or equal to, it's going to be an equal to, and I do that by adding an s3 to that. So when I do that, the result will be 3x1 plus x2 plus 10x3 plus 7x4 plus s3, and again, the S's should not be directly over each other. They are three different values. And then I can put equals and then 520. Now, the next thing I have after that are the constraints x1 is greater than or equal to 0, x2 is greater than or equal to 0, x3 greater than or equal to 0, x4 greater than or equal to 0. I do not have to put those in the matrix, so I'm done with those at this point. I do, however, have to put the object function, the thing that needs to be maximized, into the matrix. It goes in as the bottom row. It already is an equation, so I don't have to add an s, but I have to rearrange the variables so that they line up with the other equations that I already have written. I have three equations written so far, and all three of them start with x1. And now the object function has the x1 over on the right-hand side of the equal sign, so it must be moved to the left side. And I can do that. It will go over to the left side as a negative x1. So that will start the final equation. Then I want to know how many x2s I have from my object function. It's 4x2, but I can't leave it as a 4 because the 4x2 is on the right side of the equal sign. It must be moved to the left side of the equal sign, which would make it a negative 4x2. Then x3 would come next. So I have a 1x3, though 1's not written in front of it, but it is a 1x3. It would have to go from the right side where it's starting from over to the left side of the equal sign, and it would become a negative x3. Or if you want negative 1x3, it doesn't matter. And then finally, I have 3x4 in my object function, but as it's written in the object function, it's on the right side of the equal sign. It must come over to the left side of the equal sign to line up with the other equations that I already have that I'm going to turn into a matrix. So it would go over as a negative 3x4. Then there's no need to add a slack variable because it's already an equation. I'm not converting it from an inequality. It's an equals already, so no need for an s. But I do have to account for the z that's part of the object function. It has a z in it, so I have to put the z, I have to keep the z in the equation. And there is an equals, and on the other side of the equal sign, the right side, because I've moved everything that was on the right away over to the left, what's on the right side of the equal sign now for the object function is 0. So now everything that I have to account for in my matrix is written in the form of an equation, and it's written so that all the variables line up now. So now I can turn it into a matrix, which I'll put right under that. Again, I'm going to do it in a little different color just so it stands out. It's a very large matrix, so we should label our columns. Again, that's not required, but it is a best practice. I will need an x1 column, an x2 column, an x3 column, an x4 column. There are no x5, so I don't need an x5. I'm going to need 3 columns for s because I have 3 s's, so I'll need an s1 column, an s2 column, an s3 column. I will need a column for z because there is a variable z that I'll have to account for. And the final column, or far right column, will be labeled RHS for right-hand side, what's on the right-hand side of the equal sign in each equation. So now I'm just going to take the equations and basically write them without the variables. The first equation that I'm going to put in that's going to become the first row of my matrix, the first equation is 9x1 plus 4x2 plus 2x3 plus 8x4 plus s1 equals 650. Now, in the matrix form, in the x1 column, I will have a 9. In the x2 column, I will have a 4. In the x3 column, I will have a 2. In the x4 column, I will have an 8. In the S1 column, I'll have a 1. There is no S2, so in the matrix, I put a 0. The first equation has no S3, so again, in the matrix, I put in a 0. There is no Z in the first equation, so in the matrix, I put in a 0. And the right-hand side value is 650. And ordinarily, I put a line between my matrix and my column heading, so I'll put that in now. It's not too late. There we go. So the first equation is done. So now put in the second equation. The second equation is 6x1 plus 2x2 plus 5x3 plus 2x4 plus s2 equals 480. Now I can just essentially write that without the variables as long as I keep the numbers in front, called coefficients, as long as I keep them in the right spot in my matrix. So for the second equation, it's going to make the second row of my matrix. In the x1 column, I have a 6. In the x2 column, I have a 2. In the x3 column, I have a 5. In the x4 column, I have a 2. The second equation has no s1, so in the second row of the matrix, I put a 0. The second equation does have an s2, so I put in a 1 in the s2 column. So the second equation has no s3, so the second row of my matrix gets a 0. The second equation has no z, so the second row of my matrix gets a 0 in the z column. And the right-hand side value is 480. So that takes care of the second equation. Now the third equation is 3x1 plus x2 plus 10x3 plus 7x4 plus s3 equals 520. So to put that into the matrix, so this is going to make my third row of the matrix. In the x1 column, I will have a 3 from 3x1. In the x2 column, I'll have a 1 from the 1x2. In the x3 column, I'll have a 10 from the 10x3. In the x4 column, I'll have a 7 from the 7x4. Now this third equation that I'm working on has no s1. That's the next column I have to fill in a value for, so I put in a 0. Again, I'm in the third equation, I have no s2, so the third row of my matrix, I put in a 0 in the S2 column. The third equation does have a 1s3, so the third row of the matrix gets a 1 in the S3 column. The third equation has no z, so in the z column I put in a 0. And then finally for the third equation, the right-hand side value is 520, so the third row of my matrix, I end with a 520. So now there's one equation left, the bottom equation, which came from the object function. It has some negatives. You've got to pay attention. Don't lose those negatives. I have negative x1 minus 4x2 minus x3 minus 3x4 plus z is equal to 0. So I can take that equation, put it, that fourth equation, in as the fourth row of my matrix. So from the negative 1x1, I'm going to put a negative 1 in the x1 column of my matrix. From the negative 4x2, I'm going to put a negative 4 in the x2 column of my matrix. From the negative x3, which can be thought of as negative 1x3, I'm going to put in a negative 1 in the x3 column of my matrix. From the negative 3x4, I'm going to put in a negative 3 in the x4 column of my matrix. Now, the next three columns of the matrix are all for S, for slack, S1, S2, S3. There are no slack values, no slack variables in my bottom equation. So in the S1 column, I put in a 0. S2 column also gets a 0. And S3 column gets a 0 in that bottom row. There is a Z in the fourth equation. So the fourth row of my matrix does get a 1 from the 1Z. And the right-hand side value for the bottom equation is 0. And that is the first matrix, or what the book would call the initial simplex tableau.